really excited to be here.
Nice hair! Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Good hair, vintage guitar, or one made to look vintage?
It was one made to look
vintage. Oh, really? Good. You could have fooled me with that.
That's my life savings right here.
I got
really?
Go.
Wow, everything's on the line for today, eh?
I understand that.
What's your name?
My name's Conall Gorman.
Where are you from?
I'm from Montclair, New Jersey.
All right, well, what are you going to share with us?
I'm going to be playing an original I wrote. It's called Backseat.
Okay. Bring it on.
Go for it. Cool.
Wedding day, Chevrolet, cans dragging down the street. She faked a smile walking down the aisle. She could barely breathe. 7 months, two more to come, another mouth to feed. 19, knocked up, it's just a bad dream. Oh, oh, oh. Take me back to 19. Wish this was a bad dream. Take me back to 19 in your backseat. In your backseat.
Applause.
Conall!
Started real strong, Like your first note, I think we were just like pulled in the Conall vortex.
Thank you so much.
And then I think you're obviously a really, really good guitar player.
Thank you
and
so
your
much.
Pocket on guitar started crumbling a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
But man, I think you sound good.
Yeah.
Conall, I think you're on the road to being a pro. I think you got a real interesting voice.
Thank you.
It's definitely identifiable. It's definitely Conall. But I'm looking just for a little bit more in the gears.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you something. You can relax.
Okay.
All right? Because the tone of your voice and even your demeanor, when you're into your thing and that I call it the Dylan look, you know, where you kind of get up and you play something amazing, you kind of look up. And you look back down. That was just...
Thank you so much.
Right? I'm telling you, man, just take your time, enjoy the ride, just be you, and I think you're going to have a wonderful experience.
Thank you so much, sir.
Let's take a vote.
I wrote down three words, 19, fearless, and talented.
Thank you so much.
That sounds like a yes to me, my friend.
Conall, it's a yes.
It's a yes.
You're going to Hollywood.
Yes. I'm 20.
And what do you do in American Fork?
I'm actually a full-time cosmetologist.
And so why did you choose American Idol to maybe possibly transition from hair to stardom?
I've always loved American Idol. My mom's a singer, so like we watched it growing up.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and she teaches theater.
And your dad?
Yeah, my dad's in the Air Force.
Oh, okay.
Your whole life?
Yeah. Growing up as a military kid, it was pretty rough.
Being in the Air Force, I've been gone quite a bit. She would have to fill that role with not having both mom and dad at home.
My dad was gone a lot of the time, and my mom was struggling with kidney disease and thyroid disease. So a lot of the responsibilities did fall on me. We actually just found out today that he's getting deployed for a year.
Aye.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Aye.
Okay, you're 20. How do you feel about that now?
It really sucks.
I love you.
He comes home every time, so I'm just lucky that that happens, but regardless, it's just so scary.
Yeah, that military life is, it's rough sometimes, yeah.
Yeah.
What are you gonna sing today?
I'm gonna sing I Can't Make You Love Me, Bonnie Raitt.
Okay, great.
Good song.
Turn down the lights, turn down the bed, turn down these voices inside my head. Lay down with me. Tell me no lie. Just hold me close. Don't patronize. Don't patronize me. 'Cause I can't make you love me if you don't. And you can't.
Started off somewhat average, and then you landed it in a space that was like, whoa, oh my gosh. If you sang from that space every time, you would be like in superstar territory.
I think she's top 10.
What?
Thank you.
There's just really beautiful things going on in your voice, especially when you settle down.
When she soars.
Yeah, it got really well done, really classy, really... Yeah. Older than your years. I just loved it, loved it.
Thank you.
You went to a place that was so pure and so angelic that it was really one of those moments where we couldn't keep our eyes off of you.
Have you never just thought, well, maybe I should just pursue this and take it seriously for a second?
Yeah, I have. It's just with my dad being gone a lot, like we're actually thinking that we might have to, like, I might have to move back home.
You're at a fork in the road.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh, I would love to. It's just hard.
Let's get your family
get
in.
Get your family in, but
don't say just anything.
Okay. Oh my gosh, okay.
She's like the perfect American Idol contestant.
Please, right?
OMG, look at all y'all. Wow.
We brought everybody.
We did.
Hi, Dad.
Hi.
Wow, what a family. Well, your angel Elleigh just sang from her heart. She was really emotional before she sang. So you, might be deployed in April, but she might be going somewhere in February.
I wrote, I think she's top 10 on my sheet. That kind of means I'm gonna say yes.
All right.
Wow. And yes, because it's a validation of what she did.
And you don't need my yes, but you're gonna get my yes. So you're going to Hollywood.
Yes. Congratulations.
I'm gonna be singing y'all an original song called Fireflies. I wrote this song about a breakup with my boyfriend. We had been friends since the first grade. Our sisters are best friends, and so are our families. We go on family trips. And so about 2 years ago, we started dating, but you know, people grow apart, and he went to a different school. We broke up, and it was really hard for me. It was, yeah, really hard.
It's hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
He was my best friend. But I realized that everything happens for a reason and God has a plan, and I'm really starting to understand that. And this song really helped me get through it.
Good for you.
Thank you.
Are y'all able to still be friends?
Kinda. He goes to a different school now, so it's a little hard, but yeah.
Well, do you miss the friendship or do you miss him being your boyfriend?
I really miss his friendship.
Well, does he know that?
Probably not.
Well,
I think time will heal that.
Yeah. Time will heal that.
Yes, sir.
Telling him will heal it too.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Or writing a song and singing will heal it.
On national television.
Yeah, it really does help.
Well, let's hear it.
Yes, sir.
I think in some ways that the heartbreak is a good thing because I got a song out of it and everything happens for a reason. But sometimes during moments like these, I really miss him.
I admit it. I was scared. I've been hurt a bunch of times. Couldn't leave the past behind. But this guy was the sweetest of his kind. And God knows he could have been mine. But I had to go and ruin it. All he wanted was fireflies dancing in the moonlight. His hand felt so good in mine to step in on the truck bed. Four-wheel drive into the sunset. Promise ring on my left finger. Said the diamonds only get bigger. Doesn't that sound like a perfect picture? Thank you. Thank you.
Wow.
Who'd you write that song with?
I wrote it by myself.
Wow.
I think that you are really talented.
Thank you.
And that you're a really good songwriter.
Wow.
And when I was your age, I had boyfriends and was trying to write songs too. My first boyfriend at 16.
He dumped me in the parking lot of the Guitar Center and...
Anyways, all that to say, Payton, it gets better,
yeah,
and
gets
so
better.
Do the songs.
It gets better.
And if you're doing this at 15, you're on to something.
Thank you.
You know, I would say keep singing, keep writing, keep singing, keep writing. Try not to give so much energy to the boys, because I did a lot of that.
Yes, ma'am.
And know that God has a plan for your life.
Yes, ma'am.
You have a promising future.
Thank you.
All right, just take the time and grow. But as far as your career is concerned, my dear, sky is the limit
Thank
for you.
Thank you.
You're an emotional person, and that's what it takes to be an amazing songwriter and artist. You are doing amazing stuff far beyond any 15-year-olds.
Okay, Payton, listen. I'm giving you a no based on timing.
Yes, ma'am.
It's just because you're in the growing phase, and I would hate to pull you out prematurely. I'd love for you to come back. I'd say try it at 3 years, 18.
Yes, ma'am.
And you'd have a real shot.
Thank you.
Lionel.
I just looked down at that 1.5. Girlfriend, if you just go away for a hot moment and come back a little bit more tidied up, I think it'll be a lot better for you. I'm gonna give you a no this time, okay, but then please come back.
Yes, sir.
Because I'm gonna hear some more of that great stuff.
All right, I'm gonna give you a yes.
There you go.
All right.
She don't deserve 3 no's.
Heck, you don't deserve 3 no's.
Can we shake your hand?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Come on.
Good job.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Hold your chin up, okay?
Okay.
I got a sneak preview, and we love you so much,
Thank
all right?
You. Yes, sir.
And you're gonna be just fine.
Yeah, it's you're
just,
gonna be fine.
You're gonna
Don't
be
worry
just fine. And if anybody gives you any problems from now on, call me, Luke and Katie, all right?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
You got a family here at American Idol.
Thank you.
Everybody's waiting, Payton.
You didn't get it? It's okay. I thought I was over, like, crying about it, but just, like, being in there, I'm, like, really nervous. It, like, brings up all your feelings.
We do hope you come back. Keep playing
yes,
and keep working on that. Keep writing songs. You're going to be a big star.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Good luck, Payton.
Thank you
very much. Yeah. Thanks, family. You'll take care.
It's okay. I'm going to use what they told me, and I'm going to work on it. And whenever I come back, I'm going to be better than what I was this time.
Are you from Tennessee? The only ten I see. That's too cheesy. It's embarrassing me. Oh, I'm a lost cause. Don't know where to live on. You're in the league that was in meant for
Good
There's just something real artistic about you that I like.
Good.
Thank you.
Yes for me.
Yes.
I'm shaking.
All right, guess what? One, two, three.
You're going to Hollywood.